Hello learners, welcome to the studio of NIOS, and I am Dr. Ritu Bakshi, Assistant Professor, Department of Educational Studies, Central University of Jammu. I am here to talk on the topic Social Science, Curricular Perspectives from Gender, Caste and Tribals. So dear learners, our today's talk will focus on the various curricular perspectives with the lens of gender, caste and tribals. Mahatma Gandhi has said, "I am uncompromising in the matter of women's rights. In my opinion, she should labor under no legal disability not suffered by men. I should treat the daughters and sons on a footing of perfect equality." So, dear learners, today we will be discussing about a few words about the situation through the perspective of gender, caste and tribal. What are the various barriers? What conditions are needed to teach gender studies and equality education? What is taught and how it is taught? And how gender and caste based inequality appears in the schools? So, we will take gender first. Women constitute roughly half of the population of India. Though Indian society has a tradition of mother worship, treatment with women is not at par with that of man in the country as a whole. You may find that from the population census statistics, whether general or scheduled caste or scheduled tribe, the less literate women are there than their male counterparts. Various reports depict less literacy rate, declining sex ratio, less women's participation in the political process of the country, mistreatments in the different social aspects, safety issues, the traditional male child obsession in the Indians. So, we can say that in our Indian society, gender equality is seen everywhere in the society. Women and men, boys and girls are taught that power is masculine and masculinity is power. And this is being taught through the books. This is being taught through the curriculum. This is being taught through the families by the roles which women play. You can have a look on the picture. And how are we taught this? I have already discussed that through families, through curriculum, through books. Yes, by the values, with the role models, with the stereotypes. Everywhere in the culture, we are taught that men are superior and women are inferior. You can have a look on the picture that in the Indian society, mostly the household activities are being done by girl child. So, we learn all this, we learn the roles to be played in the society by the value system which is being given by the family. Not only family, by the role models, that is mother, father, what roles they are playing in the family, the students are actually becoming like that. And curriculum, it is also one of the major factors to contribute towards the gender inequality. So, there are so many barriers which stop the girl child to grow properly. Why do the statistics reflecting women's literacy, their enrollment in primary, secondary and higher education or their dropout rates read so poorly? This is the major question. Second question, what do they tell about women's access to the education? What systematic errors we have aided in this and what can be done to remedy the situation? So, this section of gender inequality highlights some of the barriers to women's education, drawing on the previous studies which are available and which are possible. So, the major barrier in the girl education is inadequate school facilities, which sometimes serve as the deterrent for the girl child's participation in the formal schooling. The chief barrier to women's education in India is the shortage of female teachers and gender bias in the curriculum. Yes, dear learners, you need to note that there is shortage of female teacher in the far-flung areas, in the remote areas, and there is great gender bias in the textbooks also, in the curriculum also. Lack of toilets, it is also one of the major factors, and it can be particularly detrimental to the girls' school attendance, where the only option of attending to the nature's call out in the open can pose both a physical as well as psychological barrier. So, lack of toilet facilities, lack of infrastructure, lack of motivation, lack of the teachers, and lack of the curriculum, proper curriculum, which promotes the gender equality. These are the major barriers. Other barriers, some of other barriers to women's education are sociological and rooted in gender stereotyping and gender segregation. Others are driven by economic concerns and constraints. A consequence of gender profiling and stereotyping is that women tend to participate more in the programs that are related to the domestic role. We have already discussed that domestic roles and values females get from their families. A mindset that views education for girls as unlikely to reap any returns ascribes to the view that investing in the education of male child is like an investment, as the son is likely to be responsible for caring for the aging parents. So, in the Indian society, mindset also matters, and women with largely a reproductive role in the society have little need for education, and any gains from it are anyway likely to accrue to the homes they go to after marriage. So, this is the mindset which Indian society has. So, there is liking for a son as compared to a female child. Women and girls receive far less education than men due to prevailing social norms and sometimes fears of violence. Pointing to the inhibitors parents feel, especially amongst the poor or backward sections of the society, Sonalde Desai, in her book on gender inequalities and demographic behavior, argues that another disincentive for sending the daughters to school is a concern for the protection of their virginity. It is interesting to observe that although women constitute a major chunk of the workforce in rural areas, especially with respect to agriculture, the percentage of women in skilled, technical and professional level in agricultural machinery, production, marketing and extension services is just around 4% according to UNESCO report. So, what we need? The need of the hour is attitudinal change, change in the mindset of the society. Because unless we change the attitude towards the girl child, the situation is not going to improve. The situation is not appreciable in a modern liberal democratic country like India, when it is claimed to have developed status in the world. Law and force are inadequate means for bringing about the social change. Social sciences as a subject, and you as a social sciences teacher, can do a lot to bring about the attitudinal changes in the learner. So, this is the responsibility of a teacher. The government has given the onerous duty to a teacher of the social sciences. So, you as a social sciences teacher can bring a lot of change by changing the mindset of the people, and by starting from the early age of the children, and by inculcating the gender sensitization among the students. So, you are very important as a social science teacher. So, dear learners, as a social science subject and as a social science teacher, you have a great responsibility to deal with. Social sciences must sensitize the future citizens of India to such issues as gender equality in the curriculum. We can see gender bias in the curriculum also. So, responsibility of a social science teacher is very onerous and very vast. Role of a social sciences teacher can be ensuring increased participation of women in education, changing the mindset in the society, sensitization and awareness building for the women's education, innovative approaches to make education available and accessible to women and enabling the policy framework. We have lot many laws and frameworks for women education, for girls education, but unless we implement this at the ground level, the situation is not going to change. So, as a social science teacher, your major main responsibility towards the society is changing the mindset of the society and catch the students early so that you can sensitize them at an early age. So, we learned that gender equality education is all about empowerment of women, communication, expression, arguing, solidarity, activism, civil consciousness, empathy, broad-mindedness, toleration, self-understanding, and life skill education. So, as a social science teacher, you have to take care of all these components when you are teaching social sciences as a subject. So, gender equality education you can provide to the students as a hidden curriculum by inculcating all these factors in the students, and this will definitely go towards the gender equality. So, dear learners, the road ahead for education of women is long and winding. Much needs to be accomplished. First thing which as a teacher, as a learner, which you need to do is to attract the girl child. Second will be to increase the enrollment in the schools, and third will be to retain, train and educate them. This is very important. Although the structural issues may be easier to address with the commitment and will of the government and local bodies, that is policy frameworks they can frame, but the psychological and sociological barriers require long term sustained efforts from all. And as a teacher, you need to remove this psychological and sociological barrier. And as I have discussed earlier, catch the students early. If you want to sensitize them, if you want to give them the gender equality education. You as a teacher can also improve the attitudes towards the girl child, challenging prevalent norms of the society, and gender stereotyping and segregation should be stopped. So, these things you need to take care of as a teacher. You can see in the picture, major household activities are being done by the female students. So, psychological and sociological barriers removal is the major responsibility which you as a social science teacher has to give. Now, we are moving towards the caste perspective. The caste in the Indian society, there is deprivation on many, many issues. The backward castes in India have been deprived of many privileges which can be social, economic, political and religious privileges. That means the backward classes in India, they are suffering from various discriminations and various deprivations, whether they are social, economic, political and religious. The deprivation is on the basis of poverty, humiliation and exploitation. That is, at the bottom of the caste hierarchy, they are suffering from poverty, humiliation and exploitation. So, how can we move up? There is need to change the curriculum, there is need to change the mindset which can provide them the equal opportunities, which can provide them equal access and equal opportunity to all the sections of the society. The need of the day is strengthening the desire of the backward caste to move up using their own ideologies and capacities for the rational and critical thinking. It is also necessary for the backward castes to develop their own capacities and qualities necessary for the entry into leadership in the work and politics. So, the question is, what you as a teacher can do towards the caste equality? You can change the mindset, you can change the curriculum, and you can teach this equality through the hidden curriculum, through various activities. You can call for the equality through skits, through dramas, and through the group work. meaningful transformation can be made in this context, the backward caste should also inculcate aspirations to self-respect and respectable lifestyles in which demeaning the traditional practices would have no place. All these actions and progress must come from below, from the backward caste people themselves, to be meaningful transformational process. Now, what is the role of education and what is the role of a teacher towards the caste equality? So, education is the most important tool, it is the most important means for creation of awakening and potential to transcend the thousands of years of discrimination and oppression. So, dear learners, the only tool which we can use towards the caste equality is providing equal education. So, education is very important tool. The central focus in the scheduled caste educational development is their equalization and non-SC population at all the stages and levels of education in all areas and in all the four dimensions, that is rural male, rural female, urban male, urban female. And this is being quoted in National Policy of Education 1986. Now, government has taken a step long ago, that is providing reservations. Will it serve or is it serving? This is a very big question. Government has a provision of various reservations in education as well as in the recruitment process as well as in the promotions. Is it going to serve or is it serving? The question then is, are reservations the way to tackle the imbalance between the castes? Reservations can offer a realistic pathway into the government jobs for the people from lower castes, but it's education that has the power to make the next generation highly competitive in the other lines of the work that the government doesn't control recruitment, that is for banking, IT and journalism, etc. So, this is a major question, that quality education is needed at all the levels and reservations only will not serve the purpose. A 2014 report found that Dalit school children still comprise the majority of dropouts, largely due to being required to work for the sake of their family's survival. So, as earlier we have discussed that they are suffering from poverty and many a times the families, they don't send their children to school because they need to earn for their family's survival. And this is being depicted in a 2014 report. So, what is the option? The only option is education, and the imparting of education, as a social science teacher, you have to impart. So, education is a potent weapon in the struggle for revolutionary social transformation. The children of backward castes need to break the age-old social and economic barriers by actively participating in the process of education. And education must lead to mental awakening and creation of social and moral conscience. So, what are the curricular perspectives which are contributing or not contributing in this process? So, education is also a means of overcoming inferior status and state of mind. So, a confident person is one who gets education. By education, people gain confidence. So, through education, the lower caste people can get the inferior get out of the inferior status and the state of mind. So, education is a very important tool for this. Curriculum needs to be sensitive to the culture, language and knowledge of the people too. The backward caste students must have the opportunity of relating what he reads in the schools to his or her neighborhood and culture. That is, our curriculum should be socially sensitive curriculum which imparts the equality education and this equality education should be accessible to all. Now, coming to the tribal's identity. The National Policy on Education 1986 states the curriculum at all the stages of education will be designed to create an awareness of the rich cultural identity of the tribal people as also of their enormous creative talent. So, this is quoted in National Policy of Education 1986. Now, as a social science teacher, the social science is the most appropriate subject to discuss the social issues like tribal perspectives of history, culture, environment, and development. Educating a tribal children has been the challenge for the government for various socio-economic, socio-cultural, ecological, and administrative reasons. Government is redesigning its strategies to create an enabling ecosystem of equal opportunity for quality education for scheduled tribe children. So, these are the efforts of the government, but as a teacher, the imparting part has been given to you. Now, what is the major challenge? One of the major concerns of the tribal education is low ST literacy rate and high ST dropout rate. Improving the ST literacy in general and ST female literacy in particular is the challenge and requires serious efforts, which is not possible without the active involvement of various sections of the people. Have a look at the census 2011 data. This clearly shows that ST literacy rate is 58.96% as against 70.04% all sections, which is the lowest among all the social groups. So, what we need to do is, we need to increase the literacy rate of ST population. Now, have a look at the dropout rates. The situation here is again very poor as compared to the other sections of the society. Reducing the ST dropout rates in the class 1 to 10th is a challenge. Bringing them back and to gainfully utilizing those who have already dropped out requires extreme care, sensitivity, imagination, and meticulous planning. So, this is very big responsibility, that is extreme care, empathy, sensitivity, imagination, and meticulous planning. And you as a social science teacher only can do wonders. No policy, no framework, no government efforts will give the desired results unless a teacher takes the responsibility of a social worker. So, you as a teacher can do the wonders. So, by studying the social sciences and by becoming a social sciences teacher, we can deal with the various issues of gender equality, caste, and tribal education. So, dear learners, today we learnt about the gender equality, the caste-based equality, and the tribal education. I hope that after this session, you will be able to know the facts about these three major identities. Thank you so much.